Hello, everybody. This is the HeyU application, and we are the ubiquitous compadres. And so, hey, everybody. All right, here we got Dylan as the driver. He will be demoing the application for today. And so this HeyU application, it allows for a locked-in patient to better communicate with their friends and family.
Double blink.
So what does a locked-in patient normally do? They are unfortunately paralyzed. They can't move. However, they can only move and shift around their eyeballs. So we wanted to be able to give them a natural way to communicate just with their eyes. So how do us normal healthy people communicate? Well, first we want to look at a person you want to speak to, and then you want to say their name. So that's the premise for our application. So we're using the Kinect sensor, the external camera, which we coded in some facial detection and facial recognition to determine the family members that he's looking at. So then using the iTribe, which is down in front of the computer, we're able to track the position of the user's eyes and then write them over onto the screen.
Long blink.
So if the user or LIS patient looks at a person, you'll see that they select them and that the system says their name. So right now he's toggling back and forth between the two conversation modes. And so if he selects one of the users on their face and then double blinks, you can say hello to that person. Let's see if he can do it.
Double blink. Hey, Patrick.
He said hello to Patrick. And now we can continue the conversation with Patrick.
How's the jazz band been going?
Very good.
So Patrick's one of the locked-in patient's friends, family friends, that maybe they came over, and he was in a band for a long time, like back in the day with him, and they just wanted to see what's going on. All right, so let's try talking to somebody else, Dylan.
Long blink.
So you toggle back. Maybe you want to say hello to one of your sons.
How are your grades this quarter?
Hey, Dad.
I want to see your progress report.
Yeah, so now we're talking to one of his sons, potentially. This is just demo, of course. Mike's one of our developers. These are all of our developers, of course. And you can actually toggle between different voice modes. Say, for example, the locked-in patient
How
is
do you like this voice?
Maybe a woman, or a British woman, or whomever.
How do you like this voice?
So let's toggle back and say hello to someone else. So maybe
hey, Chris.
Maybe his wife. Yeah, so this was a very fun application. We implemented a lot of technologies,
What's
the iTribe, the Kinect. We included some OpenCV, public facial recognition stuff. We did cross-compiling with C# and C++. And we're able to have a great product. The responsiveness is pretty fast. We can calibrate. We're also using this external monitor out here, so the audience or their family knows what's going on inside the locked-in patient's application. If they're being detected properly, if they're properly labeled, maybe they want to shift around or like talks among themselves, and they want to make sure that their family member, the locked-in patient, can have access to speaking to them. So that's most of our app. I'm Frank. I'm one of the head developers. I did a lot of the Kinect stuff for OpenCV and facial recognition. And this is Dylan here. Here you go, Dylan.
Hey, I'm Dylan. I'm an undergraduate here, computer science major.
I'm Ian. I'm also a computer science undergraduate.
I'm Kristen. I'm one of the graduate students in this project.
Hi, I'm Mike. I'm an undergraduate computer engineering
major.
My name is Patrick. I'm one of the graduate students in this group.
Hi, I'm Jason. I'm an undergrad, and I'm an electrical engineering major.